how it's going. The only issue now is the makeup. Raincoat thing can literally just go on top. So then, does it still go on? Oh, it still goes off easily. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, then. That's still going to go off pretty easy, I think, actually. Right.
Whoa.
Oh, maybe not. Yeah, it still will. Still will, don't worry. Okay, so it's a little bit squish. It's a little bit squish. So the thing is, it will do up. I know it will. But do I want to be starting with a case that will barely do up? I want to say it's not even that heavy.
Are you ready for a giggle? Do I look like a joke? Yeah,
I mean, the only issue with that is this isn't in it. All my jewellery. Still the backpack on it. So, I mean, the zip is dodgy as fuck, but I've still got that. So, I could do that. There is nothing stopping me doing that and shoving this in here. Also, my loofah. I wouldn't just ward off that in my bag, by the way, just so you know. Now it's a bit heavy. I feel better. Let's undo it. So, this is the Osprey Faraday, I think. What does it say? Osprey Farpoint Day. Farpoint Day. That's what this one is. I think it's 50 or 55 litres. This is the Volt 65. So, like, I don't want it. I don't want it. We're going to have to just go with Beth's. We're going to just have to. I feel better. I feel good. Right, let's then start pouring the chips down. These are going to fit on roses. I just don't have the suitcases.
What a day. What a day.
Rubbish, huh?
Yeah, just rubbish. Okay, so I have to use the pulley hooker thing to get the thing down, but I have to stand on the chair because I can't reach it without it. You see, the loft scares me. I can't lie to you guys. Excuse me. That's actually a really good chair. I think it's wasted in the. Okay, do you want to see my loft? Oh my god, you haven't even seen my loft yet. It's like we're not even friends. Look at this. Pretty fucking impressive, if you ask me. Okay, let's go. Hope you're not scared of heights. It's a bit scary up here, actually, isn't it? Welcome to a loft. I'm not really meant to be uphill about telling someone I'm up here, because if I fall to my death, no one's gonna know. Just shove all my stuff in the corner. That's not mine. This is from the previous owner. So this could be useful for me, actually. I could put my books in it. That's a good idea, isn't it? But I'll bring the books up separate because I don't like the idea of carrying heavy things up on my own. It's a whole other room, you know? Like, I could just, you know? I could make a gym up here, maybe. I don't think I can actually do anything with the loft though. Like, I couldn't make it into a room. I don't think I'm allowed. It's actually quite far down, isn't it? And this is really, like, quite vertical. That would be a good shot. Would you stay there? Mm. You know what I said? I should probably tell you when we're going up the stairs. Oh, fuck. Are you okay? You lived! You lived!
When you're drinking a Starbucks drink and you get ice through the thing, what do you do? Do you put it back in or do you eat the ice? I put it back in. I don't like eating the ice.
Wish me luck.
I got so many books. So many books. Have I read them? I'll leave it up to you. Oh, this is silly. I'm taking too many books up. If I fall, you gotta call someone, okay?
This is my memory box. I have a box of memory stuff.
I've had this for many years. Many, many. I don't even remember who that's from. Probably me. See, look, this is my Maid of Honor thing. Papa got me this. Stupid, I know. That's me and sister. And then lots of cards. I like keeping cards. A lot of them are from me. Oh, that was from a boy. He got me this ring. This one here. It was very special. So I keep the stuff. He's not in my life anymore, but we wish him the best. This is me as well. God, they're all from me. Literally, all of these are from me. This is me as well. Speak of the devil and she may appear. These are all from her, and you know what's really special? She wrote on the back of all of them. That's really special. Oh, can't show you these. I shouldn't really have these anymore. It's not like I'm gonna be like, kids, look at this. They would need therapy. Aww, aww, uni friends. This is my travel journal from when I was in Australia. I can't read this because I will cry. That's with a boy in Oz. We went to, we did dates. Ah! This is the boy from Oz. So funny. Honestly, it's just like death, resurrection, death, resurrection. I was not okay. Interesting. Yeah, I forgot about that. Some cards from Alice. This was always my favourite card from Alice. Like, she wrote this ages ago, and this is the first card I ever received that had the whole thing filled. And I just thought, wow, that's amazing. I wonder if she remembers this. I don't have my phone, I should probably, because like, this is stuck in my mind, you know? This was Fresh's photos. This is definitely from Laura. Yeah. She wrote me a haiku. That was me on a night out. This was Soul Jam. Soul Jam was my favourite night out ever in the world. Like, it was a thing. Whoa, we're going really old now. This is secondary school. And so in this photo, oh my god, Reese. That's so funny. So me and Amber are the two galleys in the middle. This is me, this is Amber. Then this is Reese and this is Adam. Like, I'm still really good friends with these two. They do not look like this now. They have absolutely glowed up. You know, they're stunning. Oh, look, when I went traveling last time to Australia, the boys made me a little pillow with their faces on, and I actually took this with me. It had a pillow in it at the time. It was just like, don't forget us. We used to be really, really close. We're still friends, but just, we were really close, you know? That's so nice. I'm going to take that with me and just cry at it. I'm going to put that in my... Oh, that's the one I'm getting. There's like childhood pictures of me. Oh my God, look at this. Me and Rosemary. I just have the memes, you know? All the memes. And like there's like cards from like old boyfriends in it. Like really old boyfriends. Oh my God, that's me and Beth. Oh my God. This is another book that Laura made me. Tits and Twat again. We were a duo and she's put our faces on Harry and Ron. So this is like, this is the story of our friendship. And she's like, not just on photos, she's like annotated. She's like given a story. Oh my God. Like we had some really fun fucking times. This is Amber's book, I think. School of Rock the Musical. Yep. What are these? Bali. This was the first card she ever got me. Fun story about me and Amber. She used to hate me. So I used to go out with this... I was going out with this guy and Amber was best friends with him. So I like was going out with this guy and I needed to be friends with Amber, basically. I needed to be friends with Amber because she didn't give a fuck. And I was like, oh my God, like you must like me. So I basically cornered her and then... she liked me, basically. She had no choice. And like, oh my God, like look at us, we were infants. Like when I say we were inseparable for many, many, many years. No, this is the first card she ever got me. Guess how old I turned? 13. That's not gonna fit, it's not gonna fit. Ah, let's put this that way then. Oh, fuck off. No! You are a good little camera. Do you know what was really nice? I'm just thinking about it now. Like, I was looking at memories of me and Amber when we were, like, 13. And now I'm her maid of honour. Maid of honour. I'm gonna cry again. But we were literally inseparable for... 10 years, like, spent every day with each other, literally. And like, we've been through some shit. Like, we've really been through some shit. I honestly don't know how she's put up with me for so long. Like, the fact that she still likes me enough for me to be her maid of honor, like, I don't think anyone will ever understand. No one will ever understand what that means to me. Oh, it's so nice. Back to regular scheduled programming.
I can't help myself. You and nobody else.
Like, look at this. Yeah. So, to the loft. The best album to ever exist of all of time. This could be crushing it. There's still so much to do, but we're gonna call it quits. Wait, well, let's just take one more thing up there so I can just show you what it looks like.
Love with you.
Oh, my little loft. Cute, hey? Oh, the light gets me every fucking time. I would do like a cute like, okay, bye, and shut you in here, but like, I physically cannot. Oh, it's quite scary, hey? Okay, bye. Girl dinner. What do we need to do? What do we need to do? This is my boot. Bye. Like that, y'all. That, y'all. Also, does everyone else agree that you can just park anywhere if you put hazards on? It is the one. Where am I stressing? Trying to get some of my ops addresses. The sun is sunning, hey? Whee! Also, how upsetting. So I got a couple of really good collaboration offers that I can't do because I'm going away. I got Refi Beauty, which is like, I only use Refi makeup products. Like, well, not only, but like my main makeup products are Refi. Like, that's basically all I'm taking traveling. So that is big shame. I think it's their new red collection, I think I saw, but I didn't read the email properly because I just got sad. And Monica Vendela, I always read it and I always think I should just learn what it's called, and then I just don't. Oh, sorry, mate. Fuck, I can't remember what it's called. It's not that I can't remember, I just don't know what it's called. Monica Vendela, and they do the gold jewelry. Well, I mean, I guess they do silver, but I only look at the gold. And I was like, no! The plan now is to stop manifesting gifted products and start manifesting payment and gifted travel, okay? Let's be specific now, because I can't just be sent things anymore. Like, it's really fucking cool. I got sent quite a lot of stuff and I got offered even more. Like, I have a list on my phone of all the opportunities that have been emailed to me. Like, I have never once emailed a single person to do a collab. They have all come to me, which is absolutely fucking wild. Like, I've never even like thought about it. Like, I've never even thought about emailing a brand like, hey, can I, well, Reagan! So the fact that like Refi, Marc Jacobs, this Monica, whatever, like the sunglass company, like, wow, Joe fucking Malone. Joe Malone! Like, that is just crazy, hey? So yeah, now we're manifesting gifted travel, gifted stays, gifted flights, you know? Paid flights, paid travel. Let's fuck the collabs, fuck the gifted stuff. Let's go straight for the paid stuff. Backpack is here, and my shampoo and conditioners and stuff. Oh yeah, much better. You can get quite a lot in here. Quite a lot in here, hey? If I don't tone up by carrying all of these things, you know. Is that a waterproof? A rain cover? Whoa. Bon voyage. See?
First time. You might need to hold it a different.
Oh, that's so cute.
Just a little so something nice to have with you. That's you will I never like need it to miss us. We will always be in your rucksack. You're going to have the best time. You will call us all the time and tell us about all the adventures. This is where I've missed someone.
Crying in tears. It's so nice. You even got baby smellery.
Yes, I did get
And baby Jay in case he dies while I'm out there.
No.
He's in case you die.
He's very sturdy boy.
Yeah, he is. Oh, that's so nice. So I'm just driving home and I can't stop crying. I think like obviously all the emotions are hitting me, but like so I just went to Home House and Anna's got me a little present and it's just like last night Abby made me a cake, Ellen made me a cake a couple weeks ago when I went to stay with her. Like, it's not even like the things. It's not the things. Like, it's just like I've got such good people around me, and like not even just like the people like buying me gifts or like baking me cakes. Like, even like I've got friends just like messaging me like, "Oh, how's it going? How are you feeling?" Like, it's just so nice. Like, I'm just so grateful for the people in my life. Like, honestly, I feel so blessed. Like, just the nicest people. Like, I'm so happy. Like, such genuine nice people. Like, yeah, it's just really, really nice. And, like, my family are just amazing. They're just amazing. Like, my older sister just is like, "Oh, why are you going? Don't leave us." And I, like, younger sister won't say it, but she is feeling it more. And it's just so nice. And I think, like, I appreciate them all the time anyway. Like, everyone. Like, I'm quite a grateful person. But, like it's just so... Oh, like, actually me leaving is going to affect people. Because I didn't think about that before, like, at all, like, selfishly, I guess. Like, I never thought, oh, like, what's sister gonna do when I'm not there? Because we see each other, like, almost daily. Yeah, like, I'm not gonna be able to do my food shop, my weekly food shop with Amber anymore. Yeah. And then we're maid of honour. It's all just like, oh my God, like, I've got such good people in my life. I'm just so happy. Just so, so happy. And it's like, oh my God, like, I'm about to go and just meet more people and do more things and just see what happens. And, like, I always have these people. I always have the people that are in my life now. And it's just so, so, so nice. She's so nice. I'm definitely doing my period, but like, it's really nice. It's really, really nice. I feel really nice. These are happy tears for sure. People like me and I like people, and that's really nice. So nice. Okay, that was all I just wanted to say. I'm just really grateful for the people. Yeah. And like going through, even just like going through the memory box today, like even people that aren't in my life now, like I was significant to them at some point, you know? And that's so nice. And they were significant to me. And like, even like I found that picture of me and Beth and it's like, ah, like we've actually been friends for so long. And like, we're not friends that like talk every day or like, but like when we catch up, it's just so nice. Like, it's just so nice. I've just got really nice people in my life. I really like it. And Mir, fucking Mir. Like, did you see how many cards I have from Mir? So many cards. And like, she, like, we have a relationship where it would be easier to fall out of it. Like, it would be easier to not keep up. It would be easier to not keep up with each other. Like, we're in different bloody countries. And like, we've both got lives and stuff, and they don't intertwine at all because we're in different countries. Like, we don't know the same, we don't really know anyone the same. Like,
But we just, she messages, like, she's been popping up every other day being like, oh my God, 6 days, oh my God. Like, she's like, have you packed the other suitcase? Come, what's this, like? Yeah, it's really nice. It's really, really nice. And I've been very, like, overwhelmed at the moment and kind of, like, introverted myself and kind of, like, backed off people. And I haven't been as good as, like, keeping up with other people because I've been overwhelmed in my own life. And, like, they'll know that. And it'll be fine. Like, there's no issue. It's just adult friendships are so nice. I'm really grateful for them. Yeah, that's it. Okay, I'm going to go to bed now. It's 7:30. I'm just exhausted from crying twice. I normally cry like once every 6 months. Okay. I was listening to Emma Bunton, Maybe. Does anyone remember that song? Such a good song. And then Thank You by Jamelia came on and that's when I fucking started. I was singing like thank you and it just felt so significant, like what's wrong with me? Yeah, just really grateful. Okay, bye. Ah! No. So, oh no, this is so sad, this is so sad, I don't even know if you can see me, so it's Sunday, I go on Wednesday, and you've just, as in the camera's just fallen off my windowsill, right? My literal windowsill, which is yay high, onto carpet. You've just fallen from my windowsill onto the carpet and the screen's gone on my camera. I can't see anything. I think you still work because you're still making the noises and I can see through the viewfinder. I don't know if you're actually recording or not because I can't see. Like 2 days before I go traveling. That's so annoying. It's fine. It's okay. Ah! Like the whole point of this camera. The whole point of this camera is to be a travel vlog camera. And now I can't use it. It doesn't look, I don't know if it's working. I can't see the screen. The screen's gone. It's black. I guess it's one less thing to carry. You fell down from the loft. You fell probably 12 foot yesterday. Twice. Two whole times and you lived. You fall off my windowsill. Which is up to my kneecap. Like, it's actually up to my, again, I don't know if you've been seeing this.
Oh, maybe it's not. Maybe it's not my kneecap. So it would be someone's kneecap.
Oh, fuck you. Camera. Okay. Goodbye forever.
Things like that.
I think you can see me. I don't know. The thing's not working. It's broken. R.I.P. But I'm just pointing you at me and hoping that you can see. So, yeah, just went to the home house for dinner. Saw Nanny J. I think she's the hardest one to say goodbye to because she doesn't have like, I can text her, but it's not like, I don't know, do you know what I mean? Like, it's not like I can just text my mum. Nanny J, she has a phone, but she's not great at it. And like, I can call her and stuff,
And then there's obviously the element of she's quite old, she's recently had a fall, managed to headbutt a glass window door, shattered that, and you know, her head. So now it's always like, but I'm planning on coming back at Christmas. That's literally 3 months away, that'll be fine. But I just know that she's a bit angry at me for leaving. She's a very stubborn woman, she's not a very emotional woman on the outside. I don't know what she's like on the inside, but I gave her a hug and I was like, okay, bye. And then she went, oh, this is the last time I'm gonna see you, isn't it? And then she was like, oh, and then gave me a hug. I'm so emotional. Why am I so emotional? So many emotions. But it's fine, it's all good, it's done, it's nice. She wants me to live my life, I'm living my life, it's all good. I think it's made me realise, like, I've become so close to my family. Like, I see Nanny J once a week, religiously, at least. Like, sometimes I take her for brunch, we go for coffee, I go round, like, oh my god, I'm getting so emotional. I was never like a family person before, but like I'm really a family person now. Oh! We'll get the tears out now so that when I'm on the plane I'm not sobbing. Okay, so back to business. So I was listening to Abraham Hicks because Abraham Hicks is like what started my spiritual journey. I don't know if I've said that before. Like, it's not a lot. It would take me 5 minutes to do this. This is why I'm doing it now.